swing.
Hip hop, don't sell out. If you ain't in it to win it, then
ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our 29th commencement exercises honoring the graduating class of 1993. This is an exciting time for J.R. Tucker High School as well as Henrico County Public Schools. This afternoon and tonight, six of Henrico County's seven high schools will graduate their classes of 93. In this connection, should any of our platform guests arrive a little late or leave a little early, please accept their apologies and understand how appreciative we are that they are in graduations at 3 p.m., 5 p.m., with us at 7 p.m., and will attend another at 8:30 tonight. Because each of us is here to share in the joy, excitement of the individual members of the class of 1993, please let us not forget that what they are experiencing, a high school graduation, occurs only once in a lifetime. Let this be their special moment. Let our response to them be appropriate for this very special occasion. Please now join me in standing for the processional and remain standing for the invocation and flag salute led by Jason Roberts. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 1993, preceded by our platform guest and the J.R. Tucker faculty.
Oh.
please join me in a prayer. Almighty God, you see your children growing up in an unsteady and confusing world. Show us that your ways give more life than the ways of the world, and that following you is better than chasing after selfish goals. Help us to take failure not as a measure of our worth, but as a chance for a new start. Give us strength to hold our faith in you and to keep alive our joy in your creation. Bless also all schools, colleges, universities, and all other endeavors sought by this graduating class, that they may be lively centers for sound learning, new discovery, and the pursuit of wisdom. And grant those who teach and those who learn may find you to be the source of all truth. Grant us also, in the course of this busy life, times of refreshment and peace, and grant that we may so use our leisure to rebuild our bodies and renew our minds, that our spirits may be open to the goodness of your creation. May God be merciful to us and bless us throughout all our days. Amen. Now, let us honor our nation with a Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated.
to our chorus and band. Their performance is always a treat for both our ears and our hearts. As I recognize our guests here on the platform, I'm asking that they stand. First, David Cackley, member of the Henrico Board of Supervisors from the Three Top District. Next, Mr. Richard Glover, member of the Henrico Board of Supervisors from the Brooklyn District. Mr. Robert V. Hall, member of the Henrico School Board from the Brooklyn District. Mrs. Kay Sears, member of the Henrico School Board from the Three Chop District. And Dr. William C. Bosher, Jr., superintendent of Henrico Schools. Our three speakers this evening have many achievements in common. They were all tapped into membership in the Science Honor Society, into Mu Alpha Theta, which is the Math Honor Society, the Foreign Language Honor Society, and the National Honor Society. In addition, they are all also in SOTA, and all three received the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. All three are Superintendent Scholars, which is an honor one achieves by placing among the top 100 scores in the county. Incidentally, let me brag on the academic environment here at Tucker. Of these top 100 scores in the county, 20 were from Tucker. Last but not least, all of our speakers will be entering William and Mary this fall. No small accomplishment in itself. In addition to her other honors, our first speaker this evening was recognized for being the good citizen she is by receiving the DAR Good Citizenship Award in her junior year. Conscientious and caring, she is also a peer mentor and has served as president of Tomorrow's Teachers. We in education sincerely hope she will be a teacher. Ladies and gentlemen, the energetic, enthusiastic, and effervescent president of the class of 1993, Allison Michelle Taylor.
Mr. Caldwell, honored guests, and class of 1993. As we sit here, waiting for that beloved piece of paper, we are looking back and remembering times gone by. We are thinking about friends, family, and a few of us may even be thinking of the many years of schooling we have endured just to get here. Graduation is a time when everyone looks back, but the real issues are in the future. Somewhere between looking back and thinking ahead, I came across two quotes which I felt applied to our lives at this time. The first is by James Hillman. He said, "The definition of sacrifice is singing your own song." While thinking about this, I found I had learned a very different definition of sacrifice, one which I know many others have learned as well. We are taught that sacrifice is overlooking our own individual needs for those of others. Paradoxically, we have also been taught throughout our education that we should value our own needs and individuality. But society does not allow for this. Society teaches us that there are expectations which we all must live up to. A few people are able to avoid conformity, but the majority of us struggle every day between our individual desires and society's. We rely on what others say is right and sacrifice our true selves in school, in the workplace, at home, and many times even with our friends. We overlook our individual feelings, goals, and ambitions for society's. This point brings me to the second quote, which is from the Gospel of Thomas, a part of the Gnostic Gospels. Thomas said, "If you bring forth that which is within you, that which is within you will bring you life. If you do not bring forth that which is within you, that which is within you will destroy you." By sacrificing our individual needs, goals, and desires, we cannot truly live the lives for which we were born, nor can we unselfishly help others. So as we walk across this stage tonight and begin a new part of our lives, let us look for that which is within us and step away singing our own song. Thank you.
Our next speaker represented Tucker at Girls State and the Foreign Language Academy in the summer of 92. She was also the recipient of the Jefferson Book Award. This year, she received the National Conference of Christians and Jews Award as a tribute to her understanding attitude and concern for all mankind. Lest you decide that she is not well-rounded, please note that she also found time to serve as co-captain of the girls' tennis team. With a grade point average of 4.4200, the salutatorian of the class of 1993, Sean Christian Worthington.
Congratulations, we finally made it. After so long, graduation is finally here. Graduation makes me think about how much everything has changed. For example, I remember the first day of second grade when I looked around my class and thought how big everyone was. At the time, we were still in reading groups, secret clubs, and we were chasing each other around the playground. We've come a long way since then. The world has been growing and changing along with us, and as we continue to grow, the world will continue to change. I wrote this poem to commemorate the perspective we have tonight on these changes. It has finally arrived, graduation night. We sit here watching the disappearing light. The sun is setting on our childhood, but the last sun's ray is the beam of memories that will always stay. From freshmen pushing each other in the halls, eating Twinkies at lunch, and bouncing off the walls, we became sophomores. In our last year of gym, the sight of green polyester shorts was pretty grim. As juniors, we heard seniors talk at graduation, while all we could do was use our imagination. I could say so much about this senior year, as we've been waiting for the day that's finally here. Yellow hall passes to try to maintain control, our teachers leaving early for potty patrol, the senior bathrooms we never got to use, the extra 5 minutes for lunch that we were very careful not to lose, the fun-filled field day that our class finally won. I could keep on, but I'd never be done. Much has changed throughout our school years. Some changes brought joy, others brought tears. Communism fell, the Gulf War is in the past. Clinton and Hillary won, the world's changing fast. We've been changing too, since we've been alive. We've grown a lot taller and we know how to drive. We've developed beauty to cover over our scars. We've learned to work hard and to reach for the stars. A word for the future I would like to give. Remember the good. Don't be afraid to forgive. Have fun, but work hard and try to do your best. But if something goes wrong, stand up through the test. Never give up hope. Remember God's love. Fight for what's right, but in your heart keep a dove. Before the goodbye, I feel thanks is due, an expression of appreciation from me and from you to teachers and parents, to each sibling and friend that has encouraged us and helped us to bring us to this end. We thank you and love you, and though we may not be near, our friendships with you we will hold very dear. We sit quietly under the stars tonight, ready to change our tassels from left to right. Through many joys and trials we've been led, and now we go to face the life ahead. Thank you.
As a junior, this young man won the Xerox Award and attended the Governor's School for Chemistry. This year, he was awarded the Bausch and Lomb Medal for outstanding contribution to science and served as president of the Science Honor Society. His name is synonymous with intelligence, as anyone who competed against his Battle of the Brains team can tell you. Ladies and gentlemen, with a grade point average of 4.5532, the valedictorian of the class of 1993, Owen William Duckworth.
Mr. Caldwell, honored guests, members of the ACLU, class of 1993. This is probably the last time the class of 1993 will be gathered in its entirety, and I'd like to take a moment to reflect on our time at Tucker and what we've learned from it. When I look back at these 4 years, sigh, I think about all the good times we've shared. We all remember events like Gorky Park's free concert, or the time our beloved assistant principal kissed the pig, and the fourth try, finally winning field day. But we've all had more personal memories of Tucker. I always remember vivid lunch discussions in Cafeteria One, my Latin buddies, chess and football biology class, late runs to Krispy Kreme, and recording music on slow days after school. Incidentally, Ford Fahm's album is available for $1 if you go see him. We all take experiences like these through life. But even with all the good times we've had, some trouble has occurred in all our lives. But we've all overcome this adversity to be where we are now. This reminds me of a movie I once saw. King Arthur comes to this bridge in the forest, guarded by a black knight. Arthur commands him to step aside in the name of the crown, but the knight responds only with "None shall pass." A duel ensues. As the struggle rages on, Arthur gains the upper hand and cuts off the knight's left arm. Arthur once again commands the knight to step aside, but the black knight retorts, "It's just a scratch. I've had worse," and renews his attack on the king. So Arthur cuts off the knight's right arm. Arthur now claims victory and kneels to pray in thanksgiving. You know, it's lucky he did this in medieval times, because if he did this now, the ACLU would probably protest this public prayer. But I digress. Anyway, as Arthur kneels, the black knight runs up and kicks him. After a sure argument, Arthur cuts off one leg. So he hops at Arthur. Arthur cuts off the knight's other leg and walks off saying, "We'll call it a draw." What can we learn from the tale of the black knight? Yes, he was insane, but he did not give up. Even as the odds mounted against him, he fought on and would not be defeated. Over our years at Tucker, we've all learned to deal with our own personal problems as they arise and not to back down. In a word, we've learned perseverance. So as you wander through whatever path of life you choose, remember never to give up. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you. Mr. Cackley, Mr. Glover, to Mrs. Sears, Mr. Hall, to Mr. Caldwell, to our young people who've spoken. And I appreciate so much the comments that have been given by Allison and Kristen and by Owen. Owen, I've tried not to taunt in the last 48 hours, and you just got rid of all of that in one fell swoop. But the truth is, we wanted to make it through today because this is a celebration of young people, the class of 1993 J.R. Tucker Tigers. Let me tell you that it also is not just your graduation. It's also an opportunity for people to have made a statement. As a matter of fact, the statement that you made was perhaps much bolder than any that any of us could have made, because the decision was yours, not ours. The first ones to step up to the plate and make that came right here at Tucker. I admire you for that. I'm thankful for that. The issue that we've laughed about, the issue that we've laughed about with Owen is so very serious for all of us, because in truth it's not an issue of prayer, it's an issue of speech. Because prayer is a manifestation of a commitment to action, and commitment to action is a manifestation of belief. And what we're talking about is believing in things, having a faith. And to deprive young people or any of us of acknowledging that we do have a faith would seem within itself not to be consistent with the Constitution of our country. As a matter of fact, fundamental to the stand that you've taken also is that we in many ways are attempting to acknowledge that for too long we have emphasized the rights of someone in exchange for the rights of everyone. And we're going to try to change that. Let me acknowledge too that even though there have been knots in my stomach with today for all the reasons that are obvious, I am thankful for the balance that is given to an issue such as this. In truth, I'm thankful for the statement that's been made tonight, because it will be a resounding one. 16,000 school districts in America, thousands of graduations taking place in June, and yet there are a handful of them who've done what you've done tonight. Let me also acknowledge that I often hear people say, "Oh, the good old days." And yet, just a few weeks ago, we dedicated a building in Highland Springs. It's an adult education center. And we took at that dedication and opened a time capsule that was placed in a cornerstone in 1925. 68 years that capsule had been locked. We opened it in front of those who were at the dedication. It felt a little bit like Geraldo with the set of different results. But in truth, we watched as they removed things from that box. And one was a dropout report. Now, often things like that don't mean much to most of the world, but it was about the good old days in 1925. That box recorded that 100 young people entered the first grade. Of that 100, 44 of them entered the ninth grade. Of the 44, 9 entered the senior class. And of the class of 9, 7 graduated. That's the good old days. I like what I see today, not what I saw in 1925. Young people are staying in school longer, gaining more. All you have to do is acknowledge those who are in front of you. We as teachers have to acknowledge that in many ways they are more prepared than we are. And we coach that, foster that, and not get threatened by it. Because in reality, these teachers have been mentors and coaches in ways that cannot be identified. Let me tell you tonight that there is one other aspect. There are 35,000 young people in Henrico County. Forgive me for being late, but I've been at two graduations, 3 o'clock and 5, and I'll make one more at 8:30, and I'll tell you, it's not repetitive, because each is different. But at this very moment, there are 35,000 young people in Henrico County, 2,300 teachers, 1,600 of us who support them. And we applaud and congratulate the Tucker Tigers, the class of 1993. who are tremendously prepared for what they're going to do. But let me tell you, there is something that you cannot see. And it's the emotion that comes with the care for one another, because they've been in an environment that's helped them to learn. And I will always demand, as my colleagues do, the rigor of academia, but an environment of laughter, but most of all, an environment of love. If you don't know how to laugh and learn and love, English, math, science, and social studies really don't mean very much. What you will take from this place, especially tonight, is an opportunity to acknowledge that which you believe, and an opportunity to acknowledge your friends. We're thankful for you and the statement that you made. Most of all, we're thankful for the fact that you've helped us to grow. We love you, Tucker Tigers, class of 1993.
Thank you, Dr. Bosher. This evening, we honor 11 members of the class of 1993. At senior night, 10 students received faculty awards which recognize those seniors who have made exceptional contributions to their class and our school for the past 4 years. The recognition consisted of a medallion and a cash award. When your name is called, please come forward and receive the second part of your faculty award from Mr. Caldwell. Jennifer Lynn Barnes. Stephanie Ann Barrett. Owen William Duckworth. Shelley Ruth Gardner. John David LaBelle. Jessica Lynn Landis. Jason Thomas Roberts. John Jason Shield. Hoi Nam Vin Tran. Sean Kristen Worthington. Our highest honor is the John Randolph Tucker Memorial Award. It is presented to the student who our faculty feels epitomizes our outstanding student body. The recognition consists of a medal, a cash award, a plaque for the student, as well as a plaque which is permanently displayed at school. Our 1993 John Randolph Tucker Memorial Award winner is Allison Michelle Taylor. Ladies and gentlemen, let's again congratulate our 1993 winners. Kay Sears, three-chop representative of the Henrico County School Board, will now address the graduates.
Because I have been a mother much longer than I have been a school board member, I feel compelled on this occasion, as on every graduation since I've been a school board member, to remind you that you're very, very special to a lot of people. So whatever you do tonight after you graduate, please do it safely, take care of yourselves, and be here on this earth tomorrow. Gentlemen, will you stand and turn and thank those who have supported you and loved you and gotten you through? And look, some of them are standing. They're so glad to get rid of you. Stand and thank your parents and your friends and those who have helped you. And as you turn around, you might thank the faculty. Henrico County School Board, it is my privilege and pleasure to declare you, upon receipt of your diploma, graduate of John Randolph Tucker High School.
Until after all of the students have been recognized. It is now my pleasure to present the class of 1993. Woo! Woo! Teresa Renee Aguiar. Kevin Jason Alexander. Gina Louisa Alexandri. Monique LaVon Allen.
Richard Radcliffe Anderson. Chantel Rose Anderson. Mark Richard Andrzejczyk Jr. Glennie Vladimir Araujo. Amanda Joyce Attuck. Stephanie Ann Barrett. Deidre Lee Bailey. Shannon Nicole Bailey. Charles Christopher Bales. Margaret Elizabeth Balsbaugh. Jennifer Lynn Barnes. Claire Elizabeth Barrett. Ayana Alberta Barrows. Christy Nicole Bass. Damon S. Bentick. Cynthia Dawn Blackmore. Yannick Joseph Blevins. Brooke Jerilyn Bobrowski. Troy Kenneth Boone. Christopher Dwayne Bowen. Melissa Catherine Bradshaw. John Irvin Braswell. Leslie Ann Britton. Justin Frank Bromelow. Kevin Douglas Brooks. Ernie Jack Brownie IV. Juan Bui. Paul Payne Burnett. Christopher Owen Carlton. Donnie Ami Carpenter. Megan Cawley. Russell Jonathan Chambliss. Michelle Steen Chastain. Neil Kurt Chaudry. Shelley Ann Clemens. Samuel Jennings Collarin. Tabitha Ann Collins. William Samuel Collins. Brandy Monique Conley. Michael James Consavage. Jody Marie Cook. Tammy Marie Craig. Katie Elizabeth Cruz. Michael Troy Cunningham. Deborah Elaine Davis. Ryan Christopher Davis. Stacy Evelyn Davis. Kelly Ann DeBoer. Borja Errol Campo. Franklin Leroy Ericott. Melissa Ann Dickert. Christian G. Dick. Eric Leonard Dobb. Scott Ray Dobb. Rachel Lee Donahoe. Jennifer Lee Doss. Kevin John Doherty. Jeffrey Scott Driver. Kelly Ann Drudge. Owen William Duckworth. Daniel Thomas Duggins. James Wong Dung. Alessandra Iglesias Durante. Patina Sue Durham. Karen Lean Dyer. Summer Lynn Edwards. Elena A. Eleftherio. Jennifer Marie Basin. Christopher Brian Farrell. Corey Boyd Pitchett. Lorena Lee Fleming. Rachel Angelita Flores. Marsha Rochelle Alger. Daniel Lamont Fry. Nancy Joanne Ferrerte. Joseph Anthony George. Jeffrey James Gilday. Jeffrey Todd Warren. Scott Michael Gardner. Shelley Ruth Gardner. Jason Preston Goff. Arthur Robert Goodwin Jr. Michael Scott Gray. Tasha Green. Deltroy Gregory. Deborah Faye Gunter.
Tara N. Capet.
Jennifer Ann Kirchhoffer. Jennifer Gwen Klossenberg. Matthew Damon Cosey. Rachel Megan Cornfield. John Davis LaBelle. Jessica Lynn Landis. Ryan Lindsay Larkin. David Edward Lemons. Karen Lynette Lewis. Amy Carol Lupa. Misty Nicole Bucart. Wade Brett Blue. Wendy Tara Lyman. Margaret Paige Lyons. Lisa Ann Marker. Shannon Marie Mattingly. Michelle Steen McAfee. Lisa Ann McMurray. Julia Diane McNay. Holly Lynn Mitchell. Melanie Verdon Mitchell. Sharon Angela Mooney. Teresa Denise Moore. Edward Lee Morris. William Lee Morris. Brian Donnell Bosby.
Trin to Quan.
Sean Patrick Reed. Elizabeth Lorraine Russiger. Layla Advani. Jennifer Lynn Rizzo. Christy Michelle Robbins. Nancy Caroline Robertson. Jason Thomas Roberts. Kimberly Ann Sacra. Thomas Charles Royer. Rudolph Joseph Schuster. Tina Marie Schuster. Christopher George Shara. Heather Ben Shields. John A. Shields. John Mark Scammer. Brandon Chase Smith. Stephen Ellis Smith. William Forrest Smith, Jr. Charles Calvin Snodgrass. Demetrius Jordan Solio. Philip Scott Sprouse. Roy Allen Stanley. Daniel Keith Stanley. Brandy Janine Stacy. Andrew Keith Stewart. William Marvin Storm. Bob Frank Tom. Allison Michelle Taylor. Melissa Ann Taylor. Sheree Cole Thomas. Michael Benjamin Thompson. Charles Scott Burke. Hip Van Tran. Brian Van Tran. Con Bill Tran. Lee I. Tran. Dong N. Trin. Lori L. Tudgay. Shan Latroy Burner. National Sky Inventor. Jody Elizabeth Bryan. Long Ty Bull. Kimberly Ann Wolf. Stephanie Lynn Worley. Adrian Burrell Webster. Brian Christopher White. April Marie Williams. Mark Edward Williams. Nicole Andrea Williams. Marie Angeline Wilson Chaver. Brad Ben Wyndham. Amy Marsha Wood. Brian Christopher Wood. Michael Joseph Woodard. Sean Austin Worthington. Toby Danielle Albro. Elizabeth Kern Zwicker. The class 1993.
seated, please stand for the recessional.
Thank you. From Virginia's 24-hour news service, this is 12 News at 11 with Gene Cox and Sabrina Squire. Meteorologist Jim Duncan and Ben Hamlin with sports.
Dear Lord, our God, we thank you for your constant care for us. Where we are today is a real...
The American Civil Liberties Union calls this a violation of the relationship between church and state.
But Henrico school officials say prayer like the one recited at tonight's graduation is freedom of speech. Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us for the late news. I'm Sabrina Squire.
I'm Gene Cox. The American Civil Liberties Union warned them against it, but three Henrico County schools did it anyway. They included prayer in graduation services this evening. Angie Miles has their story.
It looked like any other graduation. 353 students marched with dignity to take their hard-earned places of honor at the foot of the podium. But the first order of business here was a prayer.
Let us pray.
Strictly forbidden, according to the American Civil Liberties Union. The ACLU says this is a breach of the separation of church and state.
Dear Lord,
Henrico's superintendent
our God,
does not agree.
Thank you for your
our efforts have been not to cause strife, not to cause a debate, but rather to bring balance to those issues which are not only church and state, but also freedom of speech, which has to be an obligation of ours as well. I hope it's a lesson for all of us.
A 13-year-old Richmond teenager is behind bars tonight in connection with last night's double shooting in Mosby Court. 21-year-old James Taylor was killed. 17-year-old Alan Booker remains in critical condition tonight after both were shot in the head at close range. Police made the arrest today, charging the 13-year-old with one count of murder and one count of aggravated assault.
Syringes found in Pepsi products over the past 2 days have alarmed some consumers, raising fear of public health and a crisis for the world's second largest soft drink maker. As Bruce Francis reports, Pepsi is questioning many of the reports and is on the defensive.
Oh my God, it is the syringe.
10 shocking scenes like this one reported in 7 states. Claims of syringes found in several Pepsi products.
It's a very shocking thing that anybody would deliberately do that.
Pepsi says that no one has been hurt and that the company has uncovered a videotape of someone inserting a syringe into the can, only to discover it moments later.
Us to confirm what we've been led to believe, that there is some degree of a hoax or potential extortion involved.
And the FDA is investigating the validity of all the claims.
After some rest and relaxation, Joseph Morrissey will be back on the job as Richmond Commonwealth's attorney. The Virginia Court of Appeals today reinstated Morrissey after a circuit court judge suspended him last week. The suspension came on the heel of 5 indictments, including bribery, perjury, and misuse of public funds. Although Morrissey has his job back, he is barred from trying to influence, retaliate, or harass any employees expected to testify against him at his upcoming trial.
Judge Ruth Bader Ginsburg is getting to know the senators who will judge her. The Supreme Court nominee made courtesy calls today. Judiciary Committee Chairman Joseph Biden says he sees no problem with the confirmation. South Dakota Republican Larry Pressler says he expects her to be on the job in October. The House has voted to bar companies from hiring permanent replacements for striking workers, but the bill now goes to the Senate, where it probably won't pass. Opponents say it would cause more strikers because workers would be able to walk out without any threat of losing their jobs.
Pennsylvania Governor Robert Casey is doing well tonight, 24 hours after receiving a new heart and liver. Casey's 13-hour procedure was considered his last hope for beating a rare genetic disease that was destroying his major organs.
Former Texas Governor John Connally is being remembered as a great public servant and a great Texan. Connally died today from lung disease.
Although Connally had a large impact on Texas politics, he's remembered most for his ride with former President Kennedy the day he was assassinated in 1963. When reflecting on Kennedy's assassination, Connally said, quote, "It made you realize in a fleeting second you could be gone, so you really have no time to waste."
The Buick Regal SE. Power everything. ABS, concert sound stereo with cassette. Air, cruise, leather seating areas, a very cool $17,999.
You're telling me I get that car with all the candy at that price?
$17,999.
That's the deal.
That's the deal.
I'm in. Buick is leading the way.
See Barefoot, McGinnis, Haley, Sadler Auto Center, and Larry's Buick before these babies disappear.
You need a truck that gets it done. Well, it's Ford Truck Month, and Ford is number one.
Ford Truck Month means great deals on all Ford Aerostars and Explorers. Now save up to $2,000 on a specially equipped Aerostar XLT, or save $1,900 on a specially equipped Ford Explorer, America's number one selling compact utility.
It's the right time to buy, because it's Ford Truck Month at your neighborhood Ford dealer.
We were talking about rain in the area earlier.
And it all just kind of died away as it got a little closer here.
Okay.
They did have some rain up in the Charlottesville area. Had a pretty good thunderstorm up that way. But that same thunderstorm made it into western Goochland County and just all fell apart. So now it's setting the stage for a rather pleasant evening around here. A cold front's moving through, but really not having much of an effect. Earlier today, temperatures warmed about normal. We had a high of 84 degrees. 85 would be normal for this time of year, so we were pretty close to that mark. 62, your low last night. Which is just about normal, considering that the normal is 62. There are your records, record high back just a few years ago, up to 98 degrees, and we'll be reaching marks similar to that by the weekend. The rain gauge is empty here in central Virginia, as it has been many days in the past. Looking for sunrise tomorrow morning at 5:48, but we should not see any rainfall now as things are settling down a bit. Forecast looking like this, generally fair tonight. Pleasant for whoever that is in the background. 64, your overnight low. For tomorrow, we're looking for a high temperature of 86, which is just a little warmer than today, but not noticeably warmer. Lots of sunshine tomorrow. Then for tomorrow night, clear down to 63, and the forecast for Thursday, now it gets noticeably warmer, up to 90 degrees. But humidity levels will still stay intact until the weekend. That's when we're very hot and humid. Armadillos and all kind of folks will feel the heat by
that. That was not an armadillo.
What was
that? Was a pot-bellied pig,
was
of which we will
pig?
Speak more in just a few moments.
Okay.
The warm pot-bellied pig.
I bet he will.
Thanks, Jason. The search for a 15-year-old missing in the James River may be over. Kayakers tonight reportedly found a body near Brown's Island. Michael Morris and his friends were playing in the river last weekend when he lost his footing and was caught in the rapids. The body found tonight will be identified by a medical examiner within the next few days.
And now the pig story. A Chesterfield County couple fighting for the right to keep their Vietnamese pot-bellied pig as a pet back before the Chesterfield Planning Commission tonight. Archie Booth and Jenny Reynolds have been working to change the law since last July, and the battle is not over yet. Nancy Tate has more.
Good boy. Good boy. Come. Good boy, Smithfield.
For almost a year now, Smithfield, this Vietnamese pot-bellied pig, has been the subject of controversy. Smithfield lives with Archie Booth and Jenny Reynolds. They say he's clean and well-behaved. He sleeps on the sofa in the house at night. He has a pen in the backyard and a swimming pool to help on those hot summer days.
He's gonna lay down.
I love this pig, and if I had to move out of Chesterfield County because of it, that's pretty bad. That's really bad.
Only one dealer can offer the cars and trucks you want at the payment you need. Only one dealer, Ashland Ford Mercury, can offer the cars and trucks you want at the payment you need. And it's not a lease. It's a new 93 Ford XLT Ranger for just $179 a month, or a new Escort with factory air for $169 a month, or even a new full-size F-150 Ford pickup for $199 a month. So hurry to Ashland Ford Mercury on US No. 1 North in Ashland or Route 301 North Bowling Green. With payments this low, they won't last long.
A group of parents standing up for their gay and lesbian children by lobbying Washington to lift the ban on gays in the military. The parents participated in a news conference today held by a group called the Campaign for Military Services. Representative Lynn Woosley of California joined in their mission. She supports her own son's gay lifestyle.
Everyone in our family openly embraces our son Michael, our brother Michael, and his choice and his sexual orientation. It is not an embarrassment to us. We are proud of him. We are proud of his ability to step up and embrace his own sexuality. And we want his life to be supported by the rest of America and by the Congress.
It's become more deadly than cancer, heart disease, and accidents. A new study shows that AIDS is now the number one killer of young adults in many U.S. cities and states. According to the Journal of the American Medical Association, AIDS and its related illnesses are the top killer of young men in 5 states and 64 U.S. cities. In 9 cities across the country, it is the leading killer of young women. Researchers examine mortality figures from 1990.
For a second straight evening, the local Braves rallied against the Charlotte Knights at the Diamond, but unlike last evening, they did not get the win this time. Rick Stoss has the story.
Donnie Elliott has been Richmond's best starting pitcher, but early on, the big right-hander struggled. This 3-run homer by Jeff Kunkel helped put Charlotte ahead 5-1 after 4. Richmond, however, would battle back. Ryan Klesko's mammoth 2-run home run to center pulled the Braves to within 2. And when Keith Mitchell stroked a 2-out RBI single, the Braves were within 1 at 5-4. Just like Monday night, with 2 outs in the 9th, Richmond put runners on first and second. But unlike Monday night, Boy Rodriguez took a called third strike to end the game. The Braves fall to Charlotte 5-4.
Check the National League board and we'll see. Atlanta wins it 2-1 over the New York Mets. Cincinnati wins big over the Giants. Montreal doubles Philadelphia. Florida shut out by the Cubs this afternoon. San Diego with the shutout at the Astrodome. St. Louis over Pittsburgh, 6-3. Colorado leading Los Angeles that game in the 7th. Check the American League board and we'll see. Baltimore wins it 4-2 at County Stadium. Cecil Fielder with a pair of home runs for Detroit in the 10-4 win at Cleveland. The Yankees win over the Boston Red Sox, and Toronto beats Minnesota 6-3.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
This has been a presentation of Channel 12 News, named Best News Operation by the Virginia Association of Broadcasters.
Is yet unknown.